Our next speaker comes to us from Washington State, traveled a long way, Dr. Tui Lauilefue. Okay, I knew I was going to get this wrong. I've been practicing it. She is a medical doctor certified in both internal medicine and obesity medicine, and she is out to raise medical standards, and she is here today to talk to us about an idea she has for doing that. Tui?
When it comes to medical research, actually, when it comes to anything, data aggregation, by which I mean lumping together groups of people or facts or behaviors, it's a double-edged sword. There's the good, the bad, but when it gets bad, it doesn't so much get ugly as it gets invisible. Let me explain. Data aggregation is about simplifying information. It takes a big data set and it gives you a way of looking at it. It lets you see the big picture. It's like that one cousin who comes over and says, "Hey, this is the week that you finally organize your closet." But by the time they leave, everything is either on a hanger or tucked away in a drawer somewhere. But that's where the trouble starts. Anyone who has ever cleaned out their closet knows this. That data aggregator cousin, they come over, they get the job done, but they are not you. And because they're not you, they just end up throwing things together that don't even belong in the same drawer, right? They just kind of stuff it all in there. But again, this is where it gets problematic. You will never be able to find that one thing that you actually really need ever again. It's the same as if it's been lost forever, as if it's invisible. This is what happens in medical research. Do you remember that demographic box whenever you fill out a survey that asks you, "Hey, put a check mark next to your race"? That box, that's the drawer that you're put into. That's what you're assigned, period. It's that box that determines what health issues get addressed and which do not. But then there are people like me. I'm a Pacific Islander, specifically Polynesian, more specifically Samoan. And the box that we have to check, the one that says Asian Pacific Islander, or Asian Pacific American, or Asian American and Pacific Islander, or Asian American and Native Hawaiian or other Pacific Islander. That's the problem. I'm a Pacific Islander, but that is not what the box says. But, I mean, close enough, right? No. By lumping together distinct groups of people, data aggregation makes entire populations disappear. There's a lot of talk out there about erasure, invisibility, how important it is to feel seen. Let me give you a concrete example. Did you know that 9 out of 10 countries with the highest obesity rates in the world are all Pacific Islands? And yet, when we look at most healthcare policies and research data, Pacific Islanders are nowhere to be seen. The root of the problem is data aggregation. It's well-intended and it's useful, but it inadvertently erases the unique health profiles and challenges faced by Pacific Islanders. It's time for a change. We need to stop lumping together diverse groups of people and instead disaggregate the data to actually capture the unique needs of specific groups, like Pacific Islanders, but not limited to us. By shifting the data practices that actually represent the diversity of people, this is foundational to creating a healthcare system that effectively serves all communities. Let's take a closer look at the obesity crisis in the Pacific. Obesity rates exceed 50%. Compare this to the 13% in Asian populations. Pacific Islanders have 3 times higher obesity rates. The disparity is glaring. When you group Pacific Islanders under the Asian Pacific Islander label, we get a misleading and dangerous picture. The inability to recognize these crucial differences downplays the severity of the obesity crisis in the Pacific. And then when you think about it, even during the COVID-19 pandemic, the same thing played out. Pacific Islanders had higher mortality rates, higher infection rates, but you wouldn't know it. By looking at the official numbers that they put out, as a result, resources were not allocated to where they should have been. Public health guidance was lacking. Pacific Islanders were dying at disproportionate rates, invisible victims of a system that didn't even see them as a distinct group. We all lost people, but we didn't have to. We cannot let this continue. So, what's the solution? First and foremost, we need a firm commitment from the medical research community to start disaggregating data for Pacific Islanders, but also for other overlooked groups. Every study, every clinical trial, every healthcare policy analysis must slow down and raise the question of who and what data aggregation is leaving out and why. What can be done about it? And it's not just about the data, right? Pacific Islanders are severely underrepresented in medicine. We make up only about 0.1% in the physician workforce. That's 0.1%. We desperately need more Pacific Islander representation. Patients are more likely to trust and follow the guidance of healthcare professionals who share their cultural background. And for a community like theirs, who still put a lot of emphasis on traditional healing practices, having Pacific Islander clinicians as trusted ambassadors can make all the difference. So here's what we can do. We need to actively recruit and support aspiring Pacific Islander researchers, doctors, nurses, other healthcare professionals. We need to partner with communities to break down those barriers to careers in healthcare. We need to build a workforce that actually represents the diversity of the people that we serve. And only then can we provide culturally competent care. So I've seen the power of this firsthand. While attending medical school in Hawaii, I met a Samoan surgeon, right? So same background, also Pacific Islander. And he showed me what difference that we could make. He showed me what was possible. He showed me that Pacific Islanders belong in medicine and that our community needs us. So when I see a Pacific Islander patient, as I walk into that exam room and I see their eyes light up, I know that I'm making a difference even before I say a word. That's the power of being seen. That's what my patients feel. And for many of them, it's the first time. This is why representation matters. This is the kind of care that I would love to see in every single community, especially for those who've been overlooked for far too long. So, this is my plea. To my fellow clinicians, policymakers, and researchers, let this be the moment that we commit to disaggregating health data. Let Pacific Islanders be visible. Let our problems be seen. Let's find ways to work together so we can finally and truly serve our community. And to everyone listening, we can build this future together where no one is ever made to be felt invisible by the data or be without culturally competent care. And to my fellow Pacific Islanders, raise your voices. Advocate for your needs. Go to medical school. We belong in these spaces. Thank you.